Thank you and welcome to the Wind Ensemble concert. I thought it would be cold, but we can't decide what we want to do, obviously, here in Kansas. So it's a nice warm-ish day, and hopefully you'll be invigorated by even more of the music that you heard tonight. The first tune, Chester, a wonderful staple in the band literature, is actually part of a three-movement suite entitled The New England Triptych by William Schumann, and of course led by our wonderful second-year graduate conductor, Riley Jerbeck. How about another hand for Riley. This next piece I'm very excited about. Zhou Tian's Symphonia is not very old, and it's a wonderful new voice in the wind world. He's been writing for some time, primarily for orchestra, and to my knowledge, this piece is very young and hasn't been played very, very much. So, and his inspirations for this are very sort of personal to him. He's a professor of composition at Michigan State University. And I'll talk briefly just about each movement. There is a pause between each movement, and we will take just a brief breather because once we get going, you'll understand why. So the first movement is entitled Noir, as in black, from grainy films and stylized black and white images from the 1940s and 50s, sort of a nostalgic throwback. He says, although it starts brightly, at its core lies the night. It starts loud, just be ready, okay? I mean, there's a big boom. So if you watch my hands go up, prepare yourself, otherwise you might jump through the roof after the first attack. Just warning you, you were warned. The second movement, entitled Transit, is inspired by the New York City subway rush hour. Each stop opens to a new soundscape, and he goes, did I hear jazz? There's a wonderful middle section that's highly inspired by jazz. If you don't catch it, we'll talk afterwards, I'll help. And then he says, someone asks, stand clear of the doors, please, as if we hear on the subway. The third movement, Arioso, in Shanghai, night of the Mid-Autumn Festival, a vocalise was conceived, a beautiful, beautiful tapestry of sound for the winds. I hope you really enjoy that movement. And then the fourth movement is entitled D-O-N-E, with hyphens, done. And when we first saw it, we were like, yeah, he was excited, I'm done. But actually, he was thinking Morse code. So in 1869, Promontory, Utah, a one-word telegraph was sent across the United States in Morse code, announcing the completion of the first transcontinental railroad. Now the country was connected as never before. A journey between San Francisco and New York that previously took up to 6 months now took only days. And some 150 years later, that word, done, is transformed here into music using the rhythm of the Morse code. So you'll hear the ensemble play a rhythm, and that is actually the word done in Morse code, which is pretty clever. Throughout the finale, the done motif is passed back and forth by numerous instruments, and an accumulation of materials sends the piece to a climax at the end, and this movement was adapted from the movement of his orchestral work, Transcend. Please enjoy Sinfonia.
Thank you. Thank you.
know you're probably sick of hearing the music of David Maslenka, but I just can't stop. He has a way of getting to us right down in our souls, and I don't think this piece is any different. He was commissioned to write for the California All-State Band, and so piece is entitled California. That simple, right? And then when you hear it, I think you'll find there's so much more power and grandeur in it than just something that sounds as simple as for an All-State Band. David believed deeply in nature and finding sounds and power from nature. And so he would try and come from singular notes. So the music will start from a single place and then grow and bloom and blossom, and then it comes back to a singular note. And I think that's part of his genius that it was. We lost him in 2017. There's still not a day that goes by that I don't think about him and his impact musically and personally on me. And so please enjoy California. forgive me. That one is like, you know, really down. So you were fine. The applause was well earned. That's why I was like, come on, give it. So thank you for that. If you didn't notice, this is the last piece on the program. It lasts for a little while. So if you don't know The Pines of Rome, okay. It's a wonderful piece by Ottorino Respighi. It's been transcribed for winds, was originally for orchestra. So, I couldn't end with California. I just didn't think it had the right leave here with a good feeling vibe, you know, but love Maslenka. If you saw, there's a table out there for Music Associates. If you have any questions about like, hey, what is Music Associates? Why is there this table with all these names on it? Music Associates is a pooled donor group of folks that support everything that we do here in the School of Music. And I think there's a Joe Emery somewhere around in the audience. He'll probably, yep, he already said hi to me. If you have any questions, by all means, grab a brochure, particularly if you are just like so enamored with everything that you're hearing, you're just like money flying out of your pocket. Just like, it's gotta go somewhere, might as well go to Music Associates. But all kidding aside, they support so much of what we do as far as student trips, student experiences. They help purchase sort of equipment and so many other things. Scholarships are one of their main endeavors as well. So by all means, if you just like really want to support what's going on here, not just the wind ensemble, but the choirs, the orchestras, the jazz bands, the keyboard, organ, everything that happens in the School of Music, Music Associates supports that. So by all means, say hi to Joe and check out what's going on. But yeah, thank you so much for being here. Pines of Rome, a fitting closer. It ends fairly large, so I think you'll understand why. I really am spoiled with riches with these students. Thank you so much for supporting live performance and being here. And Pines of Rome, check it out.